It's been a few days. I'll be the first to admit that. It's Matt. I've been dealing with a kind of an ongoing back problem that's kind of flared up in the last couple weeks. Right around when I was actually trying to shoot a video for the bike and kind of more or less ending up having to redo it, so yeah. It is a very sunny Thursday apparently. We're, I guess, having some sod put in the back, so hopefully the people meandering around the property won't make too much noise and interfere with this. But yeah, just kind of cleaning up the area around the bike. I'm having smashed that windshield apart. That was a load of fun. And remember, kids, acrylic windscreens suck. It's just like an acrylic cup, you know. You put them in the water, in the dishwasher, and they get all crazed and messed up at the bottom. Eventually, they split and break apart. They don't like heat either. Oh, one thing I forgot to mention, and some people with the double bubbles have this issue, is because of the way these are just because the way these zero gravities are shaped on some bikes, you can actually get the optical focal length for the various, you know, from an optical perspective, lenticular structures that are present in the windscreen. Basically, that double bubble where it comes down to the V in the front there. If you've got one, you know what I'm talking about, that where the contours come down and integrates into the lower part and into the lower shape. That can cause a localized hot spot. It happened to me a little bit. I got a little bit of melty goo on my top of my gauge cluster from where it happened. Here, I'll spin the camera around. It's pretty visible. Just that right there. It's either a reflection off it, which I think is the most likely case, actually. Because I used to, back in the days of employment, when I used to leave the house, this thing would be parked outside. Oh, man. Oh, God. Shit. Yeah, my back is just toasted. I don't know what's going on with it. I got a disc that's come apart and whatnot. It's high lumbar, so I can still bend over and whatnot. I just got this section of my back that's kind of, the muscles, they're so tense, they kind of don't let the spine move, so it's kind of like a fusion in a sense. It's kind of weird. But as long as I'm gentle with it, and I try to push on it every now and then just so the darn muscles don't go crappy on me for lack of use. Whew. Bike's been sitting a minute. Tires are a little down. Yeah, back one feels alright. Front one feels a little mushy. Yeah, no, maybe not. Man, I'm just not used to these tires on this nice clean concrete. We had this thing cleaned a while back, the floor of my garage here, and what I mean by cleaned is I had a jug of coolant burst from my last flush job, and what flush job was that? It must have been a flush job on my old minivan because there was transmission fluid in it. And I think it was during that flush job I discovered that the tranny cooler had a pinhole leak in it. I wish I could have seen the inside of that transmission. Undoubtedly had coolant contamination. Would have been just awesome to see. And it shifted. It was great. You could drag racing with it was pretty good. I mean, it had bang shift. There's probably no frictions left,
no friction material left in there. Oh, sheesh. That thing was such a turd. But yeah, the high detergent content of the tranny fluid mixed in with the coolant just totally did a strip on the garage floor. And when I finally got all the residues off, I'm like, wow, this is actually really nice. I had an oil spill not too far before that. We had some people, we had a mouse problem, and so we had a bunch of people come in and turn the place upside down looking for stuff and blah blah blah. And in the process, they haphazardly restacked some of my yet to be disposed of oil jugs, and it caused one to burst. And we're talking about maybe a gallon of used oil. I think maybe a quart got loose on the floor. I mean, I got lucky. The garage door stopped it. I came out here one morning, and the thing I had just done with the bank the previous day was, it was on a Sunday. I did an oil change, and on Monday I was going to go to work, and I come out the garage, and I see this huge oil slick, and I'm thinking, oh my God, what? Oh, what did I do? What did I not put in? I'm freaking out. And And I look over, and I just happen to sketch out of the corner of my eye a drip coming from the thing, caught the gleam of the sunlight. I was like, wait, that? But as luck would have it, because those people came in and they jostled all the containers, which I had carefully placed in the most fragile container material, or that, the containers made of the most fragile materials were, they were placed elsewhere, and, not stacked on each other. They sat in their own catch trays, because I knew they could break at any moment. I mean, unfortunately, I'm recycling old water jugs, what can I say? Some minor inherent risks with doing that. Oh, my motion sickness. Oh yeah, minor bit of discomfort in my back doing that. It's not so bad. It's interesting because I can. It's how much compensation I put into this damn camera stand. I can push. But I can't pull. It's weird. It's a pressure thing because that disc. It's so weird. When I talked to my doctor about it at first, we're sitting there and he's probably looking at me going, "Do you want medicine? Are you just here for pills? You want them damn some Amish kids?" I'm sitting there thinking, I'm like, how do I put this in terms of, And then I finally was able to come up with examples, and that kind of blew the doors wide off this thing, and yeah. So that's, in short, for a while I was unable to actually like take a tool like this, just my wire strippers, and hold it out like that. That would actually hurt my back. Do I think I could do that with a full jug of water right now? No. I did this with a 4 or 5 pound sack of groceries the other day, just kind of reaching for something, or normal arm movement as you walk. And just, oh my God, what's going on? All hell broke loose. I'm just setting up for a video on checking your throttle position sensor. Is it correct? Whatnot. So, had a piece of copper wire, insulated copper wire out of the old toolbox. Veteran SV guys, you know what this thing is. This is the dealer tool. This is a diagnostic tool. This 1 cent piece of wire. Oh, wait, no, it's copper. Oh, this is copper. Excuse me. This 7 cent piece of wire. Oh, man. It's 100% oxygen free copper, too. Oh, no, I'm kidding. I've been watching this. Australian bloke's videos. He's an electronics engineer. Oh God, I just love it when he attacks the high-end audio industry, monster cable and all that, with the
crazy oxygen-free cables and blah, blah, blah. Now, about the only thing where I bought into their hype, and go Hawks, the only reason I bought into any monster hype, and the only reason I have any of that stuff is their power cords are nice and flexible because they got that really high strand count wire in there. And so they're pretty tough. So if it's an electronic application, it's going to be unplugged and replugged in a lot and in and out of the device a lot. I'm not saying all the fancy-smanchy BS they claim about the product to make things better and shielded this and that. No. None of that crap works. None of that crap means anything. Mostly because this is the digital age, but when it comes down to the rudimentary cord construction, and I could probably find one in a couple minutes if I looked hard enough in here, when it just comes down to how well I found something with a cord on it. My power drill. Excellent example. It's just kind of got one of those cords. It's a really soft, it comes in and wants to wrap over itself real easily. And it's also, oh yeah, you dig in that. You dig in the chuck key holder, aren't you? Ooh. Anyway, the one thing I noted about the monster cables is, you see how this one's got a bunch of certification on it right there? 300 volts, 90C, internal structuring, the metric for the gauge, and then the American wire gauge value, 18, et cetera, and some other certifications I'm not familiar with. Let's see, 90C over here, and 60C over here. So, yeah, I mean, and this is kind of what the monster cables were like. They were this kind of like robust stuff. And I was like, it's the main input-output on a power supply that's drawing a lot of juice. For the practical reasons of low, plug contact, resistance, I could maybe see buying the lowest end one in your range because it had the same type of super flexy cable. But anyway, I think the product that I have from them is like a power strip or something like that. And there's some wild claim in there that you fill out this form and we will cover up to hundreds of thousands of dollars worth of stuff hooked up to it. So my former roommate had the idea, let's plug in all my stuff, plug in all your stuff, we'll occupy all the ports and we'll take a picture of it. And I won't say what all we plugged in there, but it amounted to about $50,000. And so we're all thinking, yeah, dude, this is totally proof, blah, 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 blah. And then we realized, going through the package, and this is where I will call shyster on even a properly functioning and not too butt-rapey priced product. The card inside that you fill out and send in to them to get the to apply for that warranty coverage or whatever, it was expired. It was a term. It was a certain term period that it was good for. And where we ended up buying this thing from, I guess it sat on a shelf for a while. Oops. That's kind of funny though, but they had these awesome, badass cords on them. I was like, if it's gonna get the shit abused out of it, might as well not, Looking at this thing. Yeah, this thing's been a good drill, by the way. Done some crazy stuff with it. I'm in no way paid to even mention any product you see in my garage, by the way.
It's just me and where my own product research has led me. So, yeah. Because Borderlands is awesome, man. Again, not paid to say that, just happy to be wearing it. Anyway, yeah. That's about it for me. Admittedly a little hungry, but not inspired to eat. I should probably eat something so I at least have some coherence of mind so it doesn't come out like these vlog videos do. Mm-hmm.
Look at me, I'm mentally just tweeted.
Donut. Man, I wish I had some donuts. You know, there's a top pot around here. Might have to do it. Might have to go get some donuts. It's a nice sunny day. Might have to take this thing out and actually charge the battery. My back feels pretty good today on account of the fact it's not raining and stormy and all that stuff blew out of here last night. It's actually beautiful outside right now. Yeah. Anyway, that's it for me. I got a video to shoot. Ciao.